This is the world in 1959. The size of this bubble represents the number of children born in the world. It was 100 million children that was born in 1959. And on this axis here, we can see the death among these children. The child mortality was 150 deaths per 1,000 children born. This axis goes from 20 deaths per 1,000 to 500 deaths per 1,000. And this axis down here, it shows the income per person. It was $3,000 per year in 1959. The axis goes from $500 all the way to $30,000. But the world was obviously very unequal. And I will show this by splitting the world bubble into country bubbles. Look. Each bubble is a country. The size is the number of births. And I will zoom up to show you what has changed since. The blue ones here are the developing countries. The brown ones here are the industrialized countries. And you can see that industrialized countries had higher income and they had lower child mortality. But what has changed? Well, I'll start the world and you can see year by year how the child mortality is falling. Here we go. It's falling, it's going down, child mortality is getting lower, income is increasing, and the former developing countries are coming into the circle here, which represent the industrial countries, and the big one there is China, coming all the way down. We have a new pattern in the world. The high-income countries have a very high income, and they have a very low child mortality. But also some developing countries have reached all the way down here, or I should say formerly developing countries. Most countries in the world are in the middle position, and some have very high child mortality and low income. Now, how fast did that change take place? Millennium Development Goal number 4 is specified by the United Nations as a lowering of child mortality with 2/3 in 25 years, that is, in one generation. But a modern way to measure that is to measure average annual rate of reduction. This is a way to measure child mortality in the same way as we measure economic growth in percent change per year. And the aim is to change the child mortality by lowering with 4.3%, more than 4%, we could say. Now, let me give you an example. Norway is a very successful country with very high income and with very low child mortality. And I will now take Norway backwards in history. Look, Norway flies backward in history and it lands in the year 1900. Norway had a high child mortality, 140 children dying per every 1,000 born. It was up here among the highest countries today, among the countries that have the highest child mortality. And now I'll make a very interesting comparison. I'll compare Norway with Bangladesh. And I'll choose in 1990, the year when we start to measure the Millennium Development Goal. Then Bangladesh had 140 children dying, exactly the same as Norway had in 1900. That was 90 years difference. And now I want to know which country will lower the child mortality faster. Norway more than 100 years ago or Bangladesh 16 years ago. Look here. Here we go. And Bangladesh is reducing in the same speed as Norway, but now it's going faster for Bangladesh. And when we reach 2006, Bangladesh reduced with 4.7. They achieved Millennium Development Goal rate and they were faster than Norway. Not to be surprised actually, because now there are vaccines, there are antibiotics. We know more about the importance of breastfeeding. So it should be able to reduce faster, and it did. But I'll give Norway one more chance. I compare Norway 1960 with Egypt 1990, the year when Millennium Development Goal measurement started. And Egypt then had 91 children dying per 1,000. And here we start. You can see how they are going down, and Egypt is becoming faster and faster in the speed, and very successful reduction, actually 5.5%. much faster than Millennium Development Goal rates. And Norway in the past could not follow. The final chance for Norway, we will compare Norway 1932. Norway had the same child mortality as Brazil had 1990. And here we go. And you can see Brazil is fast. Norway goes into the Second World War. That was a difficult period. They hadn't had any chance to go as fast in that period as Brazil did the last 16 years. Brazil reached amazing 6.3%, much faster than Millennium Development Goal rate. And this tells us, in practice, Millennium Development Goal can be achieved. Now, let's look how Norway continued. Norway was indeed, in history, very successful. But it reached down to its present position by a reduction of 3.3% per year. And the other countries of the world, well, these green ones, they have achieved Millennium Development Goal, exactly as Bangladesh, Egypt, and Brazil. Or they are very well on the way to achieving them, because we continue to measure up to 2015. And the yellow ones here, the yellow ones are countries which have sort of gone in Norway speed. They have reduced child mortality, but not really as fast as the target set by United Nations. 2-3%, 4% perhaps. Our concern are the red countries. Look, the red countries up here have a high child mortality and almost no reduction. They've reduced very little or not at all. And the main concern for me is that these countries have the lowest income and the highest child mortality. It means that the countries with the highest child mortality are those which also have the slowest reduction. That's a real serious concern. We must make vaccines and treatment reach those in greatest need. Now, there's a good news. Look at this country here. Tanzania, according to the measurement from 1990, has insufficient reduction. But I'll show you a more detailed study. Look here. This is published in The Lancet, the main medical journal, in April this year. And it shows on this axis the years from 1990, and here it shows child mortality. And Tanzania, indeed, during the first 9 years of Millennium Development Goal measurements, did not reduce at all. It was a red country. But what has happened is this. Now they have a fast reduction. And the researchers that did these careful studies, Tanzanian researchers together with international researchers, they were careful. They said, this is a short period and there is an uncertainty range. These little lines like this shows the uncertainty range. But they said it's highly probable because at the same time, certain actions were taken. And we have marked them here. The Tanzanian government doubled the health budget. Tanzania has economic growth now. The aid organizations provided vaccines and immunization through an international coordinated effort. And bed nets were provided that protects the children against malaria deaths. So we have good reasons to believe that Tanzania now actually is a country on track to Millennium Development Goal after a period of 9 years stagnation. Good news. I have a final graph, the total number of children who dies in the world. We actually know this estimate fairly well. We know that in 1970, there was more than 15 million children dying. And this has declined so that today it is less than 10 million children dying. And if we continue as we do today, it will continue to decrease, but too slow, I think, and many who, like me, have been able to study this. We are eager that we move faster, because what can be done with what we have in our hands today is this. If we add bed nets to everyone that needs it, we will save 1 million children. And if we add new vaccines, which now exist for protection of children against pneumonia, infection in the lung, we will save 2 million children. And if we provide services for pregnant women and newborn children, we'll save another 2 million. We can save 5 million children every year within 10 years. That is achieving the Millennium Development Goal. It is within our power to replace funerals for children with happy children.